So the tank is now set up and ready to receive the fish. This is a Lake Tanganyika African-themed aquarium. Let's take a look at the stocking and let me explain what we're doing here.
Well, currently and obviously, we are temperature acclimating the fish. They've been in these bags for over 24 hours, and I'm going to explain something really important that we have to do to ensure their best chance at survival. But right now, I'm just acclimating them to the temperature of the aquarium. The fish that we got are some Regani, also known as the Julies. We've got some Multifasciatus shell dwellers, also known as multis. It's gonna be difficult to see them right now. And then of course we got some Goldhead Compressaps. These guys aren't looking too good, but I hope they survive and do well in this aquarium. Now let me explain the stocking. First and foremost, the layout of the tank. Shell dwellers need their shells. I made sure they had at least three each. They will create territories in each one, they will create homes, and they will breed prolifically once established. I then started to create this rock pile. This is mainly for the Regani, these guys right here. Hopefully they will spend most of their time darting in and out of all of these rocks, as they are not a shell dweller. They won't bother with the shells, but perhaps might go after some of the fry, which will be interesting to see some natural predator instincts in some of these fish. Then of course, the compressaps. What I'm hoping here is these guys will more so be more of a feature fish and fill out the midsection to the bottom. So this will be heavily active near the bottom of the aquarium. The fish could actively swim around the entire tank or the entire scape, offering visual blocks. Meaning that if a fish needs to escape, it easily can escape the visual line of the fish chasing it. I've also added in some Java fern mats just to increase the height of the actual scape. Now over time, all of these plants are gonna grow and expand and shoot off additional leaves, and they're just gonna completely fill out this rock work, and I think it's personally going to look absolutely stunning. So with any luck, the shell dwellers will remain over on this side, the Regani or Julies will remain within the rock work, and the compressaps will fill out the rest. At least that's the plan.
At the very least, this is going to be an absolutely fascinating aquarium to follow along with the progress, see how everybody reacts. Did we plan this out properly? Is the stocking compatible enough, or will the scape make up for those compatibility issues? I think we're going to do okay. My only fear is the compressaps are not doing well after that 24-hour flight, and I know many people are saying, get them out of the bags. I want to temperature acclimate them so as not to shock them. Anything else as for pH or water hardness or anything like that doesn't matter. Fish are immediately impacted by temperature. As for pH, they can be shocked if it's dramatically different, but it takes weeks to actually acclimate to pH when it comes to freshwater fish. Here's how you have to get them out of the bags. Ooh, but first I think we need to discuss what's actually going in the bags and why I do it the way I do. First and foremost, what I'm going to do is cut the bag open and dump the fish immediately into a net. That water is going to go below through the net and dump into a bucket. I don't want this water within my water. Reason being, cross-contamination. Now, while the fish could be carrying parasites, pathogens, or something else that might contaminate the aquarium, this is an empty tank. I'm introducing them into a tank that has no other fish, so this is almost like their quarantine. If one of these fish are sick, I can treat the whole tank. It's pretty much a quarantine tank. Now, if these guys were being added to a tank with established members, I would quarantine these fish for 4 to 6 weeks. I would medicate if necessary, but quarantining is just a time to monitor the fish and behavior, make sure they're active and healthy and are not going to contaminate and destroy the rest of your aquatic life. With that said, I've said it a number of times. These guys have been in the bag for about 24, maybe 25 hours at this point. What's going on in that bag is what's important, and that's why I get them out immediately. I'm not gonna open the bag and drip acclimate. These aren't coral. What's going on is simple. These guys are breathing, they're producing oxygen, or carbon dioxide, and of course ammonia, waste within the water. What's all actually happening within a closed sealed bag though? Well, we know that when we add carbon dioxide to a water column, what happens? The pH will drop. Now, what happens when the pH gets below neutral into the acidic levels? well, that ammonia that they're creating is no longer nearly as toxic when it's actually alkaline above 7. So right now, they've created a ton of oxygen or ton of carbon dioxide within the banks. The pH has dropped. The ammonia in the bag isn't as nearly as toxic. So if I open this bag, immediately we're going to get a gas exchange. Oxygen is going to enter the water column, and because that carbon dioxide is now gassing off, what happens next is the pH of the water is going to rise dramatically fast, like almost immediately. What happens next is that ammonia within the bag comes immediately toxic. Now, what a lot of people will do is they'll open the bag, they'll drape it over the side, they'll add a little bit of tank water, acclimating them that way. Don't do it that way. You're going to give your fish the least amount of chance. This is the tried and true way. I acclimated thousands of fish this way and never had one actually die from the acclimation process. But now we're looking at these compercepts. Look at them. Just kind of laying around in the bag. They're active when I come over to it. The back one is where I'm concerned. We got a few laying down. Oh, see if you guys can see this. Coolies are doing fine. These guys are going to be fine, I believe. And the multifasciatus, the shell dwellers will be fine. These guys are the ones that keep laying down and looking kind of weird. But these guys are absolute stunners. Let's get them all out of the bags. They've acclimated for about 20 minutes. The temperature within the bags is the same as the water. So I'm going to introduce the multifasciatus first, the shell dwellers. They are the smallest and could be preyed on first, so I'm going to try to get them to come down to their shells just like that. That was a perfect introduction. Go on in there, guys. Don't get caught in the net. There. And what did they do? They went directly for the shelves. Let's see if we can find any. It doesn't look like we're gonna see any right now. This is perfect. Oh, there's one in the back there. Yeah, so this is absolutely perfect. Now, these shell dwellers are going to get multiple times better, bigger, but they will be able to occupy these shells for life. I do see some of them in the back there, if you guys can see them as well. I want to introduce these guys first, of course, just because they're so small. Make sure they get to their shells before we introduce some of the bigger ones. Now, I don't want to cause any confusion like I'm adding fish to a freshly set up aquarium. You guys will remember that all we did was take all of the biological media responsible for the nitrogen cycle that's housing all of that bacteria from an established aquarium and put it on this one. The substrate is also established as well. So it's basically like I did a massive water change and then added them to the tank. Otherwise, we would have had to cycle the aquarium properly, which can take 4 to 6 weeks minimum, and I've shown you a multitude of ways on how to properly do that. You don't cycle your aquarium, your fish will die. So we're pinching the top to ensure that no oxygen is getting in the bag. You're gonna tip it up, put it over the net, and just like this. So these are the Julies. Oh, aren't they pretty? I'll give you guys two shots here. Let's make sure they can go this way. I want them to come this way. And there they go. There's some of them. One out of the net, guys. So seconds in, they're acting normal. These guys' mouths aren't big enough to eat the similis, but you never know. They could just attack and kill them. It does look as though most are coming over here. Now we'll do the second bag of these guys. Out of all the fish, I would say the Regani here are doing the best, then the shell dwellers, followed by the compercepts. Once again, we'll try to get them over to the rock work here. So guide the net down like that. Back it out, let them swim into it. Yeah, and for the most part, they're going into that rock work. There are some over here as well, swimming around the shells. Look at that little shell dweller right there. See him right by the rock? There he is. And then some are within the rock work hiding. Keep in mind, we literally just added these fish. Oh, we got a shell dweller way over here. You're way out of your territory, my friend. Let's see what the Julie does, interacts. Swims right by it, doesn't care. Of course, these guys are just newly introduced to the tank. They're just going over their territories. They'll lay down
They're not too excited about this right now, but of course they do need time to acclimate. This tank is gonna be absolutely fascinating to follow along with. I can't wait. Let's move on to some of the compercepts, see what happens there. Okay, this is the first bag of the gold head compercepts. Let's see here. These guys are stressed. They're not actively swimming out of the net as I had hoped. Unfortunately, losses can happen. It's not very common for me to lose a lot, but again, I'm not entirely confident with these guys, but hopefully with luck, we do get a pair or a trio, and we'll see what happens. Yeah, this little guy. So most are doing fine. Look at the weird look on this guy. This guy's laying down a bit. So we might lose a couple. Unfortunately, it happens. They were in the bags for 25, 26 hours, but the tank is to proper temperature. They were temperature acclimated. They, of course, it is ammonia free as well. Tons of plants to help soak up the nitrates. We'll see how this tank goes. We got one more bag to add though. This is the type of stuff that I love to show on my channel, which is the real deal. I could sit around all day and hide things and hide deaths and you know, not show you losses and act like this never happens. And then when it happens to you, you're at a loss. Like, oh, wow, I'm such a failure. No, there are things happen within the hobby and it happens to everybody. The internet is just a weird place where some people pretend that they are what they are not simply to build their image. I don't care about that stuff. I care about the real deal. Oh, yeah. These guys certainly are pretty, but I think we've got... Oh boy, we might have a couple that might not make it. In fact, I think there's one right there. I think overall, we've got 20 of these guys and we might lose maybe 5 of them. Man, that guy doesn't look too well. We got a floater in here. No, he's breathing. You're going in. Go on in, rest at the bottom of the tank. There, you moved. Oh, please. Yeah, you should be okay, maybe. Long flight, long time getting here, guys. I think you're gonna be okay. He's not doing so fantastic, and neither is he or he. But we looked at the bags, and we're kind of expecting something like this. Ultimately, these are the biggest fish in the tank. They will get the biggest, and they are more of a feature. And when you order fish, especially this quantity, you do need to account for DOAs, which is dead on arrival. Most, every shipping place, or every place where you can buy fish online, will have a dead on arrival policy. So you can typically get your money back. For me, once they're in the aquarium, it's in my hands. You know, if the tank isn't properly set up or I didn't acclimate them properly, that's on me, not the company. But something like this, you know, the flight was quite long. Got a few. I think they'll do okay. I'm gonna leave them alone. We'll dim the lights. And I think this tank is gonna look a heck of a lot more active once the fish acclimate to their surroundings and of course become more comfortable within it. It's interesting to see the Julies over here, but of course some of the fish are already going inside the rock crevices and whatnot, so that's pretty interesting. I know a lot of them are just laying down right now, but this is the type of fish that actually does that. Like, look at this little bunch. They'll just lay down when they are stressed or nervous or, you know, something like that. The Lamprolongus are not, the compercepts are not a hardy or easy to keep fish. These are a more challenging fish, with the others in this tank being far more easier. But I did want to do a mix, do something different, do something interesting, and give you guys something fascinating to follow along with. Whew, 48 hours later, we have 100% survival rate. Everybody has settled in, looking fantastic. They are accepting food. I'm going to give you guys a closer look at the tank now. Let me know what you think. I love it. So overall, the stocking looks to be compatible, even though we're so soon into it. But most importantly, the scape of the aquarium works. We have what we planned actually happen. Shell dwellers are dwelling within their shells. The Julius Chromis or the Julies or the Regani, are pretty much sticking to the rock structures within the cave systems, and really just exploring the entire aquarium. I do see some of the Julies come over here and check out some of the shells, but they stay mostly to the bottom 25% of the tank and always within the rock structure as planned. As for the gold compercepts or the gold head compercepts, once again, these guys are kind of doing the same thing. They never hide, yet they always kind of stay close to cover. They do venture out the highest in the aquarium, going so far as high as probably to 75% of the top, unless I'm feeding and then everybody comes to the surface. For the most part, the shellies never really do. You gotta make sure you're dropping food over them. But overall, this tank is an absolute success, and I gotta say, I cannot wait to watch the progress of this, see how the fish develop over time, see what happens, see if there's any more compatibility issues. Of course, as the tank matures, things could potentially change. Now, of course, I always stand off to the side here, and a lot of the fish come over here and hide, but when I'm not around, they definitely act more natural going to their habitats. Let's see, the Julie's following me a little bit. But yeah, I absolutely am thrilled with it. Look, so as you can see here, let me just adjust this for you guys. We've got a couple of the compercepts back there. We got another one up pretty high. Just exploring, that's his overlook. I do find a lot of them come back here and then swim up and overlook their new territory and what everybody's going through, and pretty much most likely gonna be the boss of the tank, where the Julies will be their annoyance. And then of course the shell dwellers will be these innocent little guys just looking to reproduce over time. We don't have any adults in this tank, but the multifasciatus, these shell dwellers, are definitely going to mature the fastest within months, within 60 days, we'll see fry. With some water changes and good food, it's pretty much guaranteed. They do enjoy, look at the chromes, or the Julies, swimming within the plants, hiding within them. This guy just swam in there and he's like laying in it. I just love watching this tank. There's so much activity and life. And I know if we stand back here, it's kind of the opposite. Like, Joey, this tank is empty. Well, not really. We do got a ton of tiny fish in here, but this is a tank where you come up and you observe it slowly and watch for it and see what everybody's doing. And the more you look at it and the more you watch and the longer you stay still and the more they get used to you, the more fascinating this tank becomes. Absolutely love this aquarium, and if you guys do too, make sure that you let me know in the comment section below. What did you think of it? Did you think this tank is the right stocking, the right scape? How do you feel? I definitely just wanted to do something different, something with some tiny fish, some cheap and easy to find scaping supplies. You guys will remember, this is just rocks from around my local area. I've used them in several tanks now. These are just escargot shells. They're considered extra large snail shells. Got them on Amazon. This is just a pool filtration sand. And then we have Anubias that I've had for years, a couple of years that I've propagated and cut at the ride zone myself. And then of course some Java fern that I just got recently, but I'm gonna be able to propagate that as well. It looks like one of the Anubias fell off, but that's fine. I can just stuff it back in wherever over time. These are going to attach to the rocks. They don't need anything else other than that, even though we did plant some of the Java fern within the substrate. Just want to make sure we don't push the sand or the plant in past its rhizome in the sand. But other than that, very easy to maintain aquarium. And once this grows in, these plants will contribute to water quality as well, producing oxygen and removing nitrates from the aquarium. I think this is going to be an absolutely fascinating tank to not only follow along with the progress, but certainly rewarding as well. But this, even though right now it's my favorite aquarium, wait till you see the others. And if you can't wait to see the other aquariums as well, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, make sure you do so you don't miss these videos. I can assure you they're not only inspiring and they'll turn out to be educational, but these are aquariums that you could potentially do at home as well. Maybe it's on a larger scale or maybe it's on a smaller scale. The bottom line is I just want you to find more inspiration and potentially even get into the hobby if you're not already.